Yeah, hi, good morning everyone. Good morning. Shall we begin the session? Today we are talking, today I'm taking the same module, that is employability and the professional development, but with the new chapter, that is chapter number 5, implementing the career development learning within higher education. That is how to implement them, how to implement that career development learning within that higher education, how to promote them, how to use them, how to make the strategies that is able to promote career development learning that can be differentiated with the specific module, that can be differentiated with the delivery strategies. So implementing the career development learning within the higher education. So first is the delivery strategies. So in these broad terms, these are three delivery strategies for promoting the career development learning that can be differentiated or distinguished. First is that through specific modules, then through more general cross-curriculum integration, then outside the curriculum. So through specific modules means some criteria, some modules will be defined that will be used with the delivery strategies that will be used for promoting the career development. That is through the specific modules. Then through more general cross-curricular integration, that is how or what is the more general cross-curricular integration technique that will be used for the delivery strategies. Then outside the curricular. Outside the curriculum includes what are the various capabilities, what are the various categories that will included in the outside or that is included in the career development that can be differentiated from the curriculums. And there are three forms of modular approach. One is a generic, one is a customized, one is a bespoke. So there are three delivery strategies that will be used for promoting the career development. So first is through specific modules, through more general cross-curricular integration, then outside the curriculum. And there are three forms of modular approach, generic, where the same module is designed to be available to students in any department or course, then customized, where a generic template is adopted to the needs of a particular department or courses. That is, as per the requirement, I am taking the customized template, I am taking the generic template that is adopted to the needs of a particular department or courses. Then bespoke, where modules are developed for a specific purpose within that particular department or course. So this depends on the strategy, this depends on the modular approach, modular design. So that is generic, customized and bespoke. And this general or generic strategies needs more limited development time and can be rooted directly in the established notion of what career development learning compromises. What career development learning means, what are the various rooted, what are the various drawback that will be available for the established notion of what career development will be taken out, what career opportunities will be taken out within that opportunity. So these strategies will be used for the three modular approaches, three forms of modular approach, generic, customized and the bespoke. And the generic strategy that needs more limited development time that can be rooted directly in the established notions of what career development learning compromising. What is the career development that compromises or that is used with the established notion? And the customized strategy that tends to lead to more active involvement of the academic staff. Yeah, one is a generic that leads to the limited development time that... Yes, this can be rooted also with the career development learning. And next, customized that tends to lead to more active involvement to the academic staff. So this is more, why? Because everything is customized as per the user requirement, as per the employees. So this is the more active involvement of the academic staff. And the bespoke strategies to more ownership by the academic staff. And the modules on the career development learning were well established in the USA in 1970s and has continued to develop there till 2003, and then again later on they are gaining a significant boost. Again they are gaining a higher education program. There will be a subsequent government funded program that focused specifically on the career management skills. And in a survey by peers, around a third of the institutions reported that career management skills module were unavailable or available to the students, and in most of the cases the take up was tiny compared to the total student population. And in one institutions, however, 25% of students took advantage of such modules. And another, it was compulsory for all the students. Then career modules typically ranges from 5 credit to the 20 credit. So that typically range from 5 to 20 through some are the larger and the number extended to the 30 or even 60 credits, at which stage they efficiently became a degree course pathway, that is a MEC crash in press, and they are also often located in a second year of the degree programs, though the final and the first degree are also used. In some cases, the credit counts towards the 360 credits that comprising a first degree are also taken into account into degree classification into others. They are also viewed as optional extras which are credited, which are academically assessed, that appears on the student's degree transcript but do not count the towards the 360 credit and degree classifications. And some universities have also developed separate awards or skill certificates for such extra provisions. In addition to or in place of such modules, career development elements can be integrated within programs by linking them to the existing course component so that the career development learning is also core rather than the taught. And they can be done on an opportunities basis. They can be done on a systematic basis. Opportunities or opportunistic basis is used by taking the opportunity, taking the advantage, how it is developed, why it is developed, and to whom or by whom it is developed. On a systematic basis, for example, as a part of the module template, providing greater transparency for the skills within each module that includes the career management skills that are also embedded within each module. And in these cases, the involvement of the academic staff is also likely to be even more and more stronger. And finally, the career development learning can be promoted through extracurricular activities. That activities includes ICT-based activities, non-credit-bearing special events. ICT-based activities includes, example, computer-assisted career development learning programs on CD-ROMs or the creation and enhancement of the websites. The non-credit includes career fairs, one-off sessions on the particular career management skills, self-presentation, or the short-term courses. Now the next part is the links to the personal development planning, that is the PDP, how we can give the linking to the PDP. So in a number of the institutions, close links have been established between the career development learning and the process of PDP, personal development planning. And the introduction of such processes is a part of the implementation of the Deering report recommendation that institutions over the medium term should develop. Let also develop a progress file designed to assess students to identify their achievements, what are the students' achievements, how they are qualified, and what are the various drawbacks, what are the various information that will be provided about these achievements to the others. So what are the various progress file that will be designed, that will be used to assist the student to identify their achievements. Now, two means are also investigated over here. First is the transcript, recording the achievements. To follow a common format, we use the transcript that records the achievement. Then PDP, that process through which the students could monitor, build, and reflect upon their PDP. That means there should be a final judgment sheet, there should be a monitoring sheet, there should be a building and reflecting upon their personal development. And all the institutions were to have implemented the PDP expects of the progress file by 2005 for the 6 versions. And the review was also suggested that the progress have been made, but that implementation was straight away variable and uneven. That means that may be changed, that may be linked, that may be used with the PDP, that is the personal development planning. And the PDP processes are relevant to and overlap with career development learning in at least 3 major respects. So how they are relevant, how they overlap with the concepts. So first of all, they help the students to translate learning experiences into the languages of the employability. So they help the students to learn or to adopt or to translate the learning experiences into the language of the employability, and also supports the reflection and the development of the self-knowledge and the skills of the reflection, recording, and the method action planning enhanced by the PDP process is also at the heart of the career management skill. That means this is the main aim. How or what are the various skills of the reflection? What are the various skills of the recording? What are the various skills of the action planning that is enhanced by the PDP processes? That is the personal development processes. So that learning process will translate, will be used for the learning experiences into the language of the employability, and also supports the reflection and the development of the self-knowledge. And they also develop a bank of the evidence that students can mine in presenting themselves effectively to future employers. The bank of evidences will be used that student can mine in presenting themselves effectively, efficiently to the future employers. And conversely, career development planning also helps to ensure that PDP processes are not limited to learning and to the present, but have a future orientation that incorporates the work and career also. It therefore acts as a crucial nexus between the undergraduate present and the future of the life after graduation. So this will be used within the or between the undergraduate, that is maybe a present, that may be a future of the life. The next is the teaching and the learning method. What are the various teaching and the learning methods? And these teaching and learning methods are used in the career development. Learning needs to meet at least two major requirements. Now the next part is teaching and the learning methods. So any doubts till now? Okay, so this teaching and the learning method that is involved in the career development planning that needs to meet at least two major requirements. First, they need to meet or they need to personally engaging, and therefore based on the active involvement of the students and use of the interactive teaching and a learning method. So they are personally engaging, they are personally based on the active involvement of the students. How students will be actively engaging in the teaching and the learning, how they're using the interactive teaching and the learning methods. Then they need to make the world of work become real, and therefore includes active involvement of the employers and where possible direct experiences of the work. Then certainly there is a room for traditional institutional or instructional method for some elements of the program that includes the teaching, that includes the academic elements of the career development theory. But these methods were unlikely to be sufficient, unlikely to be used. So personally engaging the teaching and the learning method that will be used, that will be maintained in the learning process, that will be engaged in the break-even analysis, how this can be done, how is this can be done. Over for the academic solution, for the academic elements of the career development theory. Now, what does this include, or whether the personal or the teaching and the learning method includes? These methods include the facilitative teaching styles that are effective, that encourages and models an open and honest exploration of the career planning process. Then using the short buzz up or the buzz group discussion within the lecture group sessions. Then self audits, example of the personal and the career development or career management skills. Then role play, that is the recruitment personnel, mock interviews. Then peer review, example CVs of the assignments. Then card slot exercises, that is example devising a sequence of the decision making activities. Then snowballing activities that begins with the paired based work, progressively combining to produce a larger group response to the challenge set. That is how these activities will be paired, how these activities will be the within the pair-based work that is progressively combining to produce a larger group response to the challenging set. The next is the problem-based methods. That is also one of the part of the employability or the pedagogy for the employability group. That is a problem-based methods. Then supplementing the lectures with online peer discussion groups or tutor-managed discussion forums. Supplement that lectures with the online peer discussion, online peer group, and also used with the tutor-managed discussion forum that will be used within the discussion group that will be used within the tutor-managed discussion forums. The next is a self-directed learning. And in addition to this, there is a potential involvement, there is a potential for the active involvement of students in the design and the delivery of the program. This can include systematic consultation of the student through surveys or focus group discussions in designing the programs, using the immediate student feedback in reviewing the programs, then contacting the formal career development or career management module students after graduation to provide the long-term feedback. This is also one of the cases that it provides a long-term feedback that involves such graduates in the delivery of the modules to the current students. So how to involve such students, such graduates in the delivery to the current student? Such form of participation can also mean that the students feel that they have a more of the say than in other areas of their higher education studies. That can also result in the increased sense of the ownership. Over their personal learning in the career development era. Similarly, when we talk about the realism in the relation to the world of the work, that also provides a compelling rationale for the active involvement of the employers in the design and delivery of the program. That can include, or this can include, involvement in the planning and development, example contributing to the definitions of the career management skills, to the production of the course planning, course material, to the staff development programs, and to the design course. Then making the direct contributions to the program delivery, example, providing or making inputs to the workshops, lectures and the seminars, and acting as a host for the project work and the placements. And particularly, it is also used with the strong areas for such involvement that includes activities relating to the recruitment and the selection process, and also using with the team building and the problem solving task. This involvement includes with a significantly with relevance to the activities and also provide the credibility to the students. This employer's motivation for involvement also includes conveying a positive image of their organization or the company, assessed to the positive or the prospective applicants.